Well, as we just spoke of the historic visit of the Prime Minister for a one-day trip to Austria, now Austria Chancellor has welcomed Prime Minister Modi to Austria. He posted a picture with Prime Minister Modi, in fact, on his social media profile X, and has written, and I'm going to quote him here, that it is a pleasure and honor to welcome you to Austria. Austria and India are friends and partners. I look forward to our political and economic discussions during your visit. Siddhant continues to stay on with us. Siddhant, what is the importance of this particular visit coming in at this point of time? How exactly is that going to deepen the bilateral cooperation between the two nations?
Well, the Prime Minister's visit to Austria is perhaps very significant, especially after he has concluded his official visit to Russia. Now, Austria is a member of European Union, but Austria has not joined the military alliance NATO. That makes Austria a neutral player in European Union. So, as far as the Ukraine conflict is concerned, Prime Minister Modi was in Russia, and both leaders had a in-depth conversation on the ongoing war. In fact, new ideas, new perspectives were discussed. Prime Minister Modi perhaps told it very categorically, and his message was very loud and clear that when children die, it pains a lot. That was the message of the Prime Minister Modi, and diplomacy, a solution through diplomacy and peace is the only option. Now, after hearing Russian perspective, after sharing India's perspective with Russia, Prime Minister has decided to go to Austria. Austria is a neutral player. Prime Minister, both when Chancellor of Austria and Prime Minister Modi will sit down for bilateral talks, both leaders will discuss the conflict, as conflict is impacting Europe quite a lot in terms of a lot of challenges in terms of inflation, high crude prices, and et cetera. So all those issues would be discussed. Prime Minister will again put forward the concerns of the countries from the Global South, and will hear out the Russian perspective and share India's perspective and position on Ukraine. Point number one. And the other than this, it would be business, technology, innovation. There's a startup bridge launch between the two countries. Both countries have a $1 billion of trade every year. How to increase the trade and how to make sure that the companies from both countries invest in each other. That is going to be the focus area.
Absolutely, Siddhant. Thank you so much for bringing us all those crucial updates with regards to both the inputs that we got for our viewers straight from Kremlin as well as from Austria right now. Shifting